In this video, I will explain how you can build a single batch web application using SaaS via Jobs. The batch will contain a dynamic HTML form, and when submitted, it will launch a job. The results will be returned back to the page, allowing user to resubmit the form as many times as they want without leaving the page. Let's first explain what SaaS via Jobs are. SaaS via job definition contains SaaS code and metadata about the parameters, the execution server, and optionally a form which can be written in JSON, XML, or HTML. The job, when submitted, executes on a compute server, which is launched on demand or picked up from a pool of already running compute servers. The results generated by the SaaS code execution can be stored on a file system, in the SaaS content server, or streamed back to the calling interface in different formats like JSON, HTML, or any format supported by the SaaS language. To build the prompts, you have different options. One of them is HTML. SaaS provides a JavaScript library which can be used to build dynamic prompts, as you will see in the demo. If you are calling the job from a web page, by default, the page will be reloaded when executing the job to display the result. In some cases, this may not be ideal if you want to resubmit the job with other parameters, for example. Using an iframe to display the result is an handy solution when you want to display the prompts and the results on the same page. I will now explain how you can bind the form elements with SAS data and add interactivity between the different form elements. The SaaS job execution web interface embeds two JavaScript files, one for jQuery and another one, which is SaaS proprietary library to dynamically load data into the forms. They are imported into script tags in line 9 and 10 of the sample file. SaaS dynamic is then initialized in the body tag and brings multiple predefined data properties like data column name, data library, data table, and data uses. These properties are used to link a form element and the SAS libraries and tables and to map the data columns. Note that the library should be defined in the compute server. It means that if you plan to use data stored in the GAS server, you should make sure that a GAS nickname engine library pointing to the GAS library is properly defined. As you can see on line 26, data uses property defines a dependency between the model select element and the make select element. This way, the end user will automatically filter the data in model select element based on the value selected in the make select element. It's now time for a demo. So this is the code that we will execute behind the scene, so the code of the job. We have just a simple prop print calling the SaaS help cars and using the macro variable model to filter the data. Then we define an HTML form. In the HTML form, we have different sections. It's a normal HTML page where we have head tag, and in the head tag, we are defining the two libraries that I mentioned, so the jQuery library and the dynamic library. The dynamic library is provided by SAS. Then we have some style elements, which can be used to style your HTML element. Finally, we have the body of the HTML page. We have the SAS dynamic init, which initializes the SAS dynamic library, and then the form. So in our form, we are mentioning that the action, so what is happening when submitting the form, is to call the SAS job execution. We have some input elements for the program. This is a default variable, which will pass the program, the name of the program that will be currently running. We have an action, which is set to execute. We have a wait to display the loader information, and we finally have the form elements. In the form elements, we see that we have a select box, and the select box to to choose a brand. We are using the data library property to define which library is used as input. So in this case, SAS Help. Then we use the data table, which defines the table that is used as input for the select box. And we define the call name make. So we will display the list of make variables. Down below, we have to choose a type, sorry. And the type will use again the SAS Help library, the scars table, the column name will be type, and we will make use of make. Make, in this case, being the ID of the select variable up front. Then we do the same for to choose the model. And in that case, you see that we are combining make and type. So basically the two form elements that we have defined earlier. We have finally the submit button. And we define after that an iframe, and the iframe will display the result. We define a small script tag at the bottom to handle the submit. So when we submit the form, what is happening? We are avoiding that the form is submitted as usually, but we are retrieving the parameters that are passed to the job, and we are executing a call to or outputting the URL into the results attribute for the source of the iframe. As a result, we are passing URL parameters, and the iframe will display the result of our execution. Let's have a look at what we have done. So I will select here the job info, copy, then paste it in the URL over here. You see that we have to choose a brand, a type, and a model. If I click on here, I get the list of available brands. Let's select the first one, the type, and then the type of car. I can submit it, and the job is then executed and returns the value. If I change to, let's say, Cadillac, we will see that here we have also trucks, and we can execute for that specific truck. So we are always keeping everything into the same page. There is no need to leave to another page, and we are displaying the result. Thanks to the SAS Dynamic library and the iframe, we can do everything into a single page and a dynamic single page application. If you need more information, you can find them in the documentation, but also on different blogs and their YouTube counterparts that are available on the SAS communities. Thanks for watching, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.